Very good morning, cadets. Hope you are all doing well. Till now we completed the topic of equality, and we also learned the fact that even the Constitution of India upholds equality, but it's evident that we come across several incidents in which the equality is not implemented in any society. We also studied about the marginalization or displacement. When development takes place, for example, construction of dams require a huge land area. Such development leads to the displacement of several people. That is what we speak about, displacement. Here is a story of one such story. A dam built across the river at sites where can collect a lot of water. This forms a reservoir, and as the water collects, it submerges vast area of land. This is because the wall of the dam across the river is high and the water spreads over a large area. This photo of submerged caused by Thehri Dam in Uttarakhand. The old Thehri Dam town and 100 village, some totally and some partially, were submerged by this dam. Nearly 1 lakh people were displaced. So this is what I told about displacement. Now few exercise or chapter review questions. 1. What issue is the Tawa Matsya Sangha fighting for? Tawa Matsya Sangha was fighting for a correct or a proper price for their product. Means product in the sense they are the fishermen. So they used to fetch or catch fish and sell the fish in the market. So they wanted just full price for their labor. Why did the villagers set up this organization? Do you think that large-scale participation of villagers has contributed to the success of Tawa Matsya Sangha? Write two lines on why you think so. So cooperative society, that is the reason why you see here, this is about Tawa Matsya Sangha, where the people they joined together, an organization, they were joined together, fisher workers cooperative organization. And why they are fighting? They are fighting for the rights for the displaced. So because of that, they started getting good price for their labor. In 1994, the government gave rights to the fishing for Tawa in the Tawa reservoir for private contractors. These contractors drew the local people away and got cheap labor from outside. The contractors began to threaten the villagers who did not want to leave by bringing in hoodlums. The villagers stood united and decided that it was a time to set up an organization to protect their rights. So what happened in this reservoir? It's quite natural that when there is a chance of getting money, the government sold the contract of fishing in the reservoir to the private contractors. So these private contractors, they started threatening the local people. And this local, they started threatening local people. the people who belongs to this particular area, they started organizing themselves and established a organizational setup. What the organizational setup? That is the newly formed Tawa Matsya Sangha. And not only organized Matsya Sangha, they also organized protest rallies like Chakka Jam or road block, demanding for their rights to continue fishing in the reservoir. You can see the few pictures, the forest dwellers, they went on protest against the policy of the government. In response to their protest, the government created a committee to assess the issue. The committee recommended that fishing rights to be granted to the villagers for their livelihood. In 1996, the Madhya Pradesh government decided to give the people displaced by Tawa Dam the fishing rights of the reservoir. So now you understand, because of the protest meeting or the protest which they led, as a result the Madhya Pradesh government decided to give the right to fishing in the reservoir to the local people. A 5-year lease agreement was signed for 2 months, signed 2 months later on January 2nd, 1997, people from 33 villages of Tawa started a new year with the first catch. So the rights of catching fish in the reservoir to the local people, which was denied by the previous one, as a result what happened, people went on protest, and because of the protest, you can see the picture of protest here. So because of this protest, the government was Madhya Pradesh government was forced to permit the locals the right to catch the fish. With this, the Tawa Matsya Sangha taking over, fisher folk were able to increase their earning substantially. This was because they set up cooperative which would buy the catch from them at a fair price. The cooperative would then arrange to transport and sell this in the market, where they would get good price. They have now begun to earn 3 times more than what they earned earlier. The Tawa Matsya Sangha has also begun giving the fisher folk loan to repair and buying the nets. By managing to earn higher wages as well as preserving the fish in the reservoir, the Tawa Matsya Sangha has shown that when the people organization get their right to livelihood, they can be a good managers. So what you would understand here is that the local people, they not only turn into good managers. So why they turn into good managers? Because they made their own cooperative society. Because of their own cooperative society, they started in getting good price. That is what we say, fair price. Okay. So they started getting fair price from the cooperative market. At the cooperative market, arrange transport and sell the fish to in a larger bigger market, where they get a good price. Not only that, whenever the fisherman wants, they were allowed to take loans for repairing or buying of nets, so that they started managing and earning money in a shorter interest from their own local area. The Tawa Matsya Sangha has also shown that the people organization get their own livelihood, not only they can be a good managers. You can see the picture of Tawa Matsya Sangha. Okay, so here you can see lady selling the fish to a cooperative society. Adoption of a song written as a part of Right of Information campaign by Vinay Mahajan. The right to know. My dream have to right to know why the centuries they have been breaking. Why don't they overcome true? My hands have a right to know. Why do they remain without work all along? Why do they have nothing to do? My feet have a right to know. Why from village to village they walk on their own? Why there are no signs of a bus yet? My hunger has a right to know. Why grain rot in godowns, while I don't even get a fistful of rice? My old mother has a right to know. Where there is no medicine, needles, dispensaries or bandages. My children have a right to know. Why do they labor day and night? Why there is no school in sight? So this is a kind of poem in which a protest or a question mark that why we are not getting facility, why we are not getting transport, why we are not getting proper health facility, why we are not getting food, that is what basic minimum requirement. Because even though we speak about India is a developing country, the GDP of India is increasing, but still there are plenty of examples where in India several thousands of people, they don't get a job or they don't get 3 times per day a meal. So there are a lot of problems. That is what the anger is expressed. The anger is expressed in this poem. Creative expression against inequality. While some join protest movement to fight inequality, others might use their pen and their voice or their ability to dance to draw attention to issue of inequality. Writers, singers, dancers and artists have also been very active in fight against inequality. Often poems, songs and stories can also inspire us and make us believe strongly in an issue of and influence our efforts to correct the situation. So don't think that chakka jam or blocking the road is the only way in which you can draw the attention of the government. There are many other ways by which you can draw the attention of the government. Indian Constitution, a living document. The foundations of all movements for justice and inspiration from all the poetry and songs on equality and recognition that all people are equal. As you know, the Indian Constitution recognized the equality of all persons. Movements and struggles for equality in India continuously refer to the Indian Constitution to make their point about equality and justice for all. The fisherfolk of Tawa Sangh hope that provisions of Constitution will become a reality through their participation in this movement. By constantly referring to the Constitution, they use it as a living document. What do you mean by living document? A living document is something which has a real meaning in our life. That is what it is called, living document. In a democracy, there are always communities and individuals who are trying to expand the idea of democracy and push a greater recognition for equality on existing as well as new issues. So Indian Constitution is considered as a living document because Indian Constitution very clearly says that Constitution recognizes the equality of all persons. Equality, please try to understand, equality doesn't mean that all are equal. It is always meant that all are treated equal before the law. So all are treated equal before the law, that is what we speak about equality. Whenever we fight against injustice, then what is the reference we give? The reference what we give is nothing but Constitution. We always say that Indian Constitution upholds equality. So Constitution is a living document. That is what we say. Constitution is a living document. Since the Constitution is a living document, it helps the people to lead the protest. That is what the Constitution is always considered as, living document. This is one more example. Over 1500 people attended a public hearing in Lucknow in 2001 to protest violence against women. Over 15 cases of violence against women were heard by a jury. Juries means board of judges of eminent women who played a role as judges. The people jury helped highlight the lack of support in the legal system for women who seek justice in such cases. The issue of equality are the central to democracy. In this book, we have tried to highlight the issue that pose a challenge to the idea of equality in a democracy. These, as you have read, include the privatization of health services in the country, the increasing control that business houses exert on the media, the low value given to the women in their work, and low earning made by small farmers who grow cotton. These issues substantially affect poor and marginalized community and therefore concern economic and social equality in the country. So in this entire textbook, or the textbook, the social and political life, what we have tried to highlight, we try to highlight the issue of equality in a democracy. We also try to highlight that health facilities, in which we studied how the government health facilities are lacking. As a result, what happened? The privatization. We have seen the storyboard of two young kids. They express their experience about the health. So in India, we have less number of government hospitals and large number of private hospitals. That leads to the privatization of hospitals in the country. We also studied about the media, how advertisement highlights a certain products, and because of this highlighting, how it increases the topic of or act of consumerism, or we purchase lot of products in the market just because we watch a colorful advertisement of those products in the TVs or in mass media. We also studied about Swapna, who grown cotton in Kurnool district of Andhra Pradesh, but sold that cotton for a very very low or less price. Like that, if you try to recollect or remember each and every chapter what we studied till now, it is nothing but highlighting one or other social issue. I repeat, it is highlighting one or other social issue which we come across in day-to-day life. This is the core of struggle for equality in a democracy. The dignity and self-respect of each person and their community can only be realized if they have adequate resources to support and nurture their families, and they are not discriminated. So what is the main core, what is the main struggle? The struggle is nothing but to treat everybody with the dignity and self-respect. Please try to understand what is called dignity and self-respect. We have to treat each and every person as an individual, that is with the individual dignity. even though he is economically, socially or educationally backward, but we should treat him with a dignity. That is what we say, dignity and self-respect. Means we should not demean or insult or disrespect any person. He may be any person in your life, any person in the sense, he may be a labor or he may be your brother, sister, colleague, whoever it may be. So it is very, very important value which we have to imbibe in our life, that we should always respect a person. That is what dignity and self-respect. And we should not discriminate any person on the basis of social, economical or educational background. That is what very, very important thing which we want to imbibe upon. Political map of India. This is how advertisements show that road safety. So please participate. Have you participated in any events related to the road safety? For materials about road safety, education, transport, all those things. Means one or other social awareness program we come across or we participate in our college life. Sorry, school life. As a NCC cadets, you are participated in the plantation drive. As a science school cadets, we participate in so lot of social awareness programs. So why we have to participate in social awareness program? Because so that we also imbibe the quality that we should always respect and contribute something to this great motherland, India. So with this, the chapter number, that is struggle for equality is over. With this, your social and political life, that civics entire chapters are over. In this, the new book, there are 9 chapters. So entire 9 chapters are completed. Please write down the question and answers what are displayed in this. Of course, there is no question and answers because this chapter is conclusion of what we studied till now. That's why exercise part is not there, but all other chapters exercise part is there. Please write down all the exercise part related to the chapter and please make a note of some of the important points which highlighted by me during the course of explanation of this particular chapter. Take care. Wish you a wonderful day. Thank you.